So today we're talking about two new products from Motorola. One is the new DROID Razr, a very, very thin Android phone. More about that later. And the Lapdock 100, a laptop-style dock for the Motorola DROID Razr, Motorola Photon 4G, and the Atrix 2. So just looking around it, you can see it's got this rather thin profile with a funky little bend in it. Screen flips up right there. On the sides, nothing. Got a power button right there. It'll also tell you what the battery charge is. On the back, you have proprietary AC charger, two USB ports, and a cable that has this little tab here that you can pull out to hook up to the phone. I'll show you that in a second. Underneath, you've got two side-firing speakers, as well as a couple of pads. And other than that, there's just that's about it. Inside, obviously, is a screen and a keyboard with reasonably good play and a multi-touch trackpad. So how does this thing hook up? Well, that's one of the first weird things about the Lapdock 100. It has this cable that with the standard Motorola HDMI, micro HDMI, and micro USB plug combo, and it goes in the top of the phone here. That much is pretty straightforward. But then the cable isn't long enough to put the phone in the slot here sideways, and it won't go in this way because of the bend in the cable. So you're left with two ways, either sticking it out like that, which seems kind of weird, or flipping it over, putting in that way, which I guess will work. It just doesn't seem like it was designed to do that. Either way, it's in. So let's take a look at this. You open up the screen and you'll notice right away that it boots right up into the Lapdock app. And remember, this is all running off of the phone. There's absolutely no processing going on inside the Lapdock itself. So you'll see over here, we have the phone mobile view, which shows us what's going on the phone. And then over in this rest of the desktop space, we can do things like launch Firefox. And this is a full implementation of Firefox, complete with Flash and doing everything that, oh, that's nice. Well, this is embarrassing. So apparently recovering the windows and tabs I had open before is not possible, probably because I messed up something in the WebTop app. Anyway, what we'll do is we'll go to Google, and you'll notice that it pops right up. And this is all, again, using the phone entirely for all connectivity and horsepower. So let's go to CNN's webpage. That's pretty rich content. And it's connecting. And or maybe not. There we go. Cyber Monday. I guess it's really busy. The internets are broken. Come on. There we go. All right. Rendered all at one time. And you can see that you can scroll up and down with either the trackpad or the keys. And it's reasonably quick, not super powerful. Feels kind of like a netbook. If you've used a netbook before, you'll know that they're not the speediest of things, but you know they'll get the job done. Let's open up another tab, and we'll go to we'll go to ESPN.com. Connecting again. We'll open up another tab and go to Amazon came up very fast, so I don't think it's connectivity. It must just be CNN. ESPN, looks like it's also... There we go. You notice that you're seeing everything that you should be seeing. Flash does work for whatever that's worth. And it's coming a little slow. Advertisers, you know, those ad farms aren't necessarily the fastest things on the planet. I'll go over to Amazon. So that was actually showing some Flash video. So it works. You can move this over to... So you could see both your browser as well as the mobile view at the same time. And you can open things simultaneously or in both places. It's actually a pretty neat environment. The quibbles that I have with this and the hardware are the trackpad is not terribly consistent. And sometimes it seems really sensitive, sometimes it seems not very sensitive. The buttons aren't terribly rewarding. The keys feel pretty good. They are a little tightly spaced, but I guess that's what you'd expect on a 10.1-inch screen device. The resolution here is 1366 by 768. It weighs about just over 2 pounds, 2.2 to be exact, and supposedly it includes a 5-hour battery, which, while it's running, is also charging the phone. So that's nice. So when you do disconnect, you know, when your plane's about to land or whatever, you'll get off and your phone should be have a nice little boost to its charge. So you notice that it went to sleep when I closed the lid. It reawakens when I open the lid. And again, it's not the fastest thing, but, you know, it will get there. For an asking price of $249, it's cheaper than just about any netbook as well. And it adds a nice bit of complementary functionality to one of the three phones that it works with. So anyway, that is the Lapdock 100. In concert with the DROID Razr, both from Motorola. Check out the review.